On behalf of Hamblin Park Presbyterian Church and the family of Tom Gates, I welcome you to this time of reflection. We gather to worship, to grieve, and to celebrate Tom's life. We rejoice that in his baptism, Tom was clothed with Christ, and Christ will clothe him with glory when he comes again. Let us pray together. Eternal God, maker of heaven and earth, you formed us from the dust of the earth, and by your breath you gave us life. We glorify you. Jesus Christ, the resurrection and the life, you tasted death for all humanity, and by rising from the grave, you opened the way to eternal life. We praise you. Holy Spirit, author and giver of life, you are the comforter of all who sorrow, our sure confidence and everlasting hope. We worship you. To you, O blessed Trinity, be glory and honor forever and ever. Amen. Let's hear these words from the Gospel of John, chapter 14, verses 1 through 3. Jesus says to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also." On the night of his arrest, Jesus speaks these words to his disciples, to his friends, those who had journeyed with him throughout his ministry and witnessed God's work of transformation and healing. They had seen the power of God on the hillsides, on the raging sea, and in the temple. But at that moment in the upper room, they are scared and confused. Jesus has told them of his imminent betrayal. He's also told them that Peter, one of the leaders among them, will deny Jesus 3 times. Their world is changing. All they have known and experienced is about to turn upside down. We can only imagine how deeply troubled their hearts were in those moments. As they hang their heads in despair or gaze listlessly into an uncertain future, Jesus speaks these words: "Do not let your hearts be troubled." Great change and upheaval is ahead of you, my friends, Jesus says, but do not be afraid. Jesus does not promise an alteration in their circumstances. Instead, he urges them to trust, to be at peace in God's welcoming and abiding presence. Jesus calls them to look forward in hope to the resurrection. He reminds them that through his death and resurrection, he will draw all people to himself. Jesus invites the disciples to see in the midst of their sadness and confusion that God welcomes them and prepares a place for them. We are here today with troubled hearts. We grieve the loss of a father, a grandfather, and a dear, dear friend. The world we knew and experienced with Tom is forever changed. We will miss all the ways he showed care to his family. We will miss his generosity. We will miss his kind and loving heart. And yet, in the midst of our sorrow, let us hear the words of Christ and remember that God has prepared a place for Tom. The words of death and sadness strive to be the last that ring in our ears, but God declares that death and pain and tears do not have the final word. Jesus Christ is risen from the grave, vanquishing the sting of sin and death. Light bursts forth from his empty tomb, and the darkness that threatens to overwhelm us is destroyed. God's love has the final word. God's love, which is more powerful than our sadness and pain. God's love gives us hope and illumines our eyes with the light of the risen Christ. And with our eyes open, we can glimpse the truth the Apostle Paul proclaimed when he said, "For I am convinced that neither death nor life, nor angels nor rulers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all of creation will be able to separate us from the love of God which is in Christ Jesus, our Lord." In Christ, God breaks down every barrier, every boundary to welcome us and to prepare a place for us. Friends, cling to the promise that God has prepared a place for Tom. Tom now rests in the loving arms of his Savior and his Lord. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. With hearts full of gratitude, let us give thanks to God for Tom's life. Let us pray together. Holy God, Lord of life and death, you made us in your image and hold us in your care. We praise you for all your servants who, having lived this life in faith, now live eternally with you. Especially we thank you for your servant Tom, for the gift of his life, for all in him that was good and kind and faithful, for the grace you gave him that kindled in him the love of God and his neighbor, and enabled him to devote his life to you. We praise you for his commitment to live generously, his faithful service to his country, his gratitude for the simple gifts of home, his devotion to his wife, his daughters, and his grandchildren. Though we will miss our dear brother in Christ, we trust in your promise of heavenly reunions. Gracious God, we also trust in your promise that for Tom, death is past and pain ended, and that he has now entered the joy you have prepared through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Friends, go out from this time, and may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, guard your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. Go knowing that the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit goes with you now and always. Amen.